Influenza A viruses originate in wild birds. Some of them may spread to other animals, causing zoonotic infections. When acquiring the ability to infect and spread among humans, there's the potential for a serious epidemic to occur. This led to influenza pandemics in 1918, in 1957, in 1968, and in 2009. Similarly, zoonotic infections to chickens have a dramatic impact on the global poultry industry. To assess the zoonotic potential of new influenza variants, we need to understand how viruses find their host cells. The target cells of the influenza virus are covered with glycans that have all kinds of functions and may act as receptors for influenza or as decoys. The receptor structure in humans is different from birds. One key point where viruses adapt is receptor recognition. The virus needs to bind multiple glycans to remain bound. At which density a virus can form enough interactions depends on the structure of the glycans. This receptor density may differ between different cells and tissues of the same host, and between different host species. We developed a biosensor to assess this highly dynamic, multivalent binding process. The biosensor visualizes in one image the threshold receptor density above which the virus forms sufficient interactions. Avian and human-type receptors have different affinities. Longer glycans can reach more binding pockets on the virus. Together, these effects control host specificity. With a better understanding of receptor recognition, we can better predict which cells and which host an influenza virus infects, and quickly assess the zoonotic potential of a new emerging virus to take the right preventative measures. And since most, if not all, viruses are multivalent, we could use the same method with different receptors for other viruses, such as coronaviruses. This may, in the end, lead to improved detection and treatment.